He's the incumbent with 10 years' experience. She's the unknown who hopes to make history. Tonight in Commitment 2010, the race for Nebraska Secretary of State, John Gale versus Janet Stewart. Capitol Bureau Chief Andrew Ozaki speaks with both of them.
Fremont attorney Janet Stewart believes Nebraska needs balance in state government. That's why the 61-year-old Democrat is running for Secretary of State.
There's never been a woman elected to be Nebraska's Secretary of State, and while gender is not a qualification, I have a different perspective.
Stewart ran unsuccessfully for Congress in 2004. She says her experience in business and law would serve her well as Secretary of State.
Somebody who has worked for a private business, who knows how to look for those cost-saving areas.
69-year-old John Gale is the Republican incumbent from North Platte. In his tenure, he's expanded online services and implemented new federal election requirements.
I'm very proud of the decisions that we have made in my office to have a much more uniform, reliable, accurate, modern election system.
Gale says he's passionate about encouraging people to vote, even occasionally donning his Cactus Jack outfit to educate kids on the issue.
To reconnect young people with a sense of responsibility and consciousness of the importance of doing our duty as citizens.
The candidates differ on allowing people to register to vote on election day. Gale calls it unnecessary since Nebraska already lets voters register when they get their driver's license. Stewart says that's not enough.
We just need to try to work toward that same day registration because that's what's important to our democracy. People come out to vote.
Stewart says the business side of the office is not always consumer friendly, a criticism Gale disputes.
Prompt, personal, professional service. That's our motto in our office. I get compliments everywhere I go.
As a member of the Pardons Board, the Secretary of State could vote on granting clemency for death row inmates. Gale supports the death penalty. Stewart does not. Both say their personal views would not affect their decisions. Andrew Ozaki, KETV, NewsWatch 7.